What's going on, guys? Good morning. Still out in the Adirondacks with Cody in the background. We're on day three of constantly climbing. Today we're at Lower Beer Wall. We might be making our way to Upper Beer Wall later. Standing at the base of Afternoon Delight. Nice moderate climb here. A little wet, but we're gonna deal with that. And yeah, this one looks interesting. Ready, man?
Let's do it.
Sheesh. Oh, seems like there's just so many ways to go. You can go straight up here, you can follow that right. Got lots of options up here. Oh, fuck yeah, dude. Oh. That was good, dude, hell yeah. Okay, go ahead and take that, and good to Lower. All right, just got back down to the ground. Thank you, dude.
Thank you, man.
I was a little nervous going into that, but Cody definitely calmed me down and got me going. Overall, great pitch. Tons of like hidden horizontals that I couldn't really see from the ground, which is why I was a little weary, but once you get up there and you're eye level with them, they're pretty deep and there's good pro. So perfect little beginner route for me. Hell yeah, thanks, dude.
You hiked it, man.
Hell yeah. Cody lowered me. I'm about to get him up on the wall and he's gonna clean all my gear. Whew. Yeah, I didn't use a single sling, did I? Rockaholic, 5'8", 80 feet, 4 stars. At the end of the low head-high overlap below a straight-in finger crack that leans left, make a bouldery start to gain the crack and a good stance. Some hard initial moves up the crack, which is the crux, lead to easier climbing. Past an overlap on the left, the crack ends at a block. Move left around this block up to a ledge. Continue up easier terrain to a tree, 80 feet. FA in 1983. By a party of three. Yo, nice job on that last climb, dude. Hell yeah.
Thanks, man.
Now we're gonna go up and try to find another climb that we can't see from the ground, but should be right up around that corner there. See the bolt.
Oh, you do? Okay.
Yep.
We're in the right place. Let's go.
Yeah. Oh, that's a good shot. Hell yeah, man.
Great time, man.
Another climb down on this beautiful day. Look at the view too, can't beat this. Potential ice climb in the background there, I gotta remember that. But yeah, thanks for putting me on that, man.
Heck yeah.
Clutch and Cruise, 5'8 plus G, 165 feet, 3 stars. An overhanging hand crack on pitch one is very popular. The incredibly loose rock above isn't. Most parties lower from the cedar or the finish on one of the variations. The grade of pitch one evokes much discussion as some believe it to be the most sandbag roots in the Adirondacks.
What?
Oh, shit. Pitch one, climb the hand crack in the overhanging left-facing corner, which is the crux. At the top, continue up the corner, now right-facing to its top. Step left and climb a broken slot to a cedar on the left with a fixed anchor, 65 feet.
So it's a lot of, can I give you a little beta?
Oh dude, spray it.
I think all the gear is gonna come out easy with the exception of that number three, which you'll be able to wiggle out from a good stance.
Cody, go ahead and lower. Yo, super solid day so far, man. This is crazy out here. Hell yeah, that crack was, I mean, it spit me out, but it was incredible. Nice job, dude. Sandbagged or no, what do you think? You're a hand jammer though. You're a really good hand jammer, so.
I think the Dax is sandbagged.
The whole Dax is sandbagged. All right, on to the next climb. Not sure what the hell we're getting into, but we're gonna go over to upper beer wall. Job today, dude.
You too, man.
Just ending off the day at beer walls here. We hit lower and upper beer wall. Just got back to the top. Beautiful view. Hell yeah.
Time for a cold one.
Definitely not our last time here. This place was awesome.
Killer, man.
Thanks for watching, guys. Catch you on tomorrow's adventure.